Yep, and there's one above it.
And then right here.
And it's got all the hair stuck all together and all looks so pretty.
We'll take care of it.
Oh.
What do we want to... Well, I'm coming in there.
Good important job.
Yeah, man, why?
I bet you can find this black bow tie, maybe.
No. It looked nice. It looked nicer than ties.
They stopped doing their black.
Twist.
They're eating.
We decided on
orange vest.
Don't think.
Those are cute. I like the
cool. You didn't get any tears out of me.
A minute.
Tons of records.
I think I only did one return on Amazon once because I found something on half the price.
My mom drove out. I like 10 o'clock.
You look very pretty.
Thank you. You look handsome.
Oh, okay.
And that's such a cute pillow. You wouldn't see with my flowers.
There's a set secret, even Will doesn't know.
Colors are looking good.
Thank you. Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and mercy and peace from God the Father and our Savior Jesus Christ be with you all. I'm Father Al Jowdy, formerly of this parish. This is Deacon Bill Keeling, forever of this parish. It's our pleasure to welcome you to this celebration of God's love. It is to the Lord we give thanks for all the blessings which have brought Caitlin and John to this hour. It is to the Lord we lift our hearts and minds and voices in prayer for blessings for years to come. As a sign of the faith we share in common and the love we have for this couple, please join in the opening song, number 314 in the songbook. Gather your people, number 314.
Thank you. Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be his name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all wild animals. But none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man. And while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man, this one has been taken. That is why the man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, and as all wisdom, you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through him, the word of the Lord.
Let us stand. Although this is clearly an Easter day, and the resplendent glory of Easter is all around us, not least in a beautiful bride and a dashing husband, I want to tell you a Christmas story anyway. Christmas will be here before you know it. This is a Christmas story that was long published in the Chicago papers by the late columnist Mike Royko. Some of you may have read it before if you're from those parts. It's about a newly married couple celebrating their first Christmas together. They have put off until literally the 11th hour on Christmas Eve the purchase of a Christmas tree for their new home. And so they go out into the neighborhood, to the neighborhood Christmas tree lot, and they see a number of trees that are beautiful, but very expensive. And they go to the owner of the lot and they say, "We're newlyweds, do you have anything that we can afford?" And he said, "Well, there's a tree here that has a few bruised branches, but I'll tell you what, since you're newlyweds, have it as my gift. Merry Christmas." And they were delighted. They put it on their shoulders and they marched off. Well, Christmas Eve ended, Christmas morning dawned, and this owner of the Christmas tree lot was making his way to Christmas Mass just as the newlyweds were leaving their apartment, and he looked up and saw in their apartment window not the tree he had given them the night before, but the most perfect, radiant tree he had ever seen in his life. And well, this guy knew Christmas trees. And so he laughed and he said, "What in the world is that?" And they said, "Well, you were so generous to us. We went to the next Christmas tree lot in the neighborhood over, and the owner there gave us also a tree that had a few imperfections here and there. But what we've done is we've hidden the imperfections and bound the two trunks up together, and we think we have the most beautiful tree in the world." And he agreed. Now, Mike Boyko thought that was a powerful image of the Christmas mystery, how in Jesus, God's humanity and God's divinity are bound together in a way that can never be separated. But I think it's also a powerful image for the mystery of the sacrament of marriage. As we heard in the first reading this afternoon, the two become one flesh. It also speaks to us about the reality of our human imperfection. Now, I have to tell you that one of the things that I enjoy most about meeting with engaged couples is getting them to identify at least one quality in their future spouse that annoys them or irritates them. It's just great fun to see them squirm a little bit, to see who's gonna answer the question first and how much time the second has to come up with a rebuttal. I want to tell you that John and Kate could not think of one thing about the other that annoyed or irritated them. Don't worry, it will come to you. I can promise you this because I can see by looking at you that although you are absolutely beautiful human beings, you are human beings. And it's our nature to be flawed and imperfect. But it's also important to be aware that it will come to you because that is what makes this moment a sacrament. For two presumably perfect people to stand before God's altar and pledge their love together would be maybe a beautiful thing and something worthy of celebrating, but it would not be a sacrament. Because in the sacrament of marriage, John and Caitlin will reflect back to us God's own love, and you know how God has loved us. In our imperfection, despite our imperfection, he still went up on the cross to rescue us. And that's the kind of love that married couples reflect back to our world, a willingness to stand before God's altar and pledge their love to someone who is maybe not perfect, and maybe who does annoy them a little bit every now and then. That is why God showers the sacrament of marriage with special healing graces. And those of you who are married in this church this hour know about those healing graces. The stories about the stories in the Bible in the Hebrew tradition are called Midrash, and one of my favorite Midrashim goes like this. At the very beginning, when God created the universe, he placed his glory in earthen vessels that were distributed all throughout the created realm. But these earthen vessels were too fragile, too weak to contain God's glory, and so they shattered, and the shards of the vessels fell all about the universe. And when God created man and woman, he said to them, "It will be your vocation, along with me, to see to the tikkun olam, the repair of the earth." That's a beautiful image for what husbands and wives do. Not just for one another, repairing the broken pieces here and there when it happens, but being healers in your extended families, your beautiful extended families, being healers among your friends and within your parish community.
We reform the original goodness and beauty of creation by your own example, by your own love that flows over beyond the two of you.
It is humbling for me as a priest who knew you when you were just children, to see how God's grace has prospered you and brought you to this hour. It's kind of, I can't imagine the hearts of your parents, Gary and Linda, and Rick and Katie. This whole community sees God's work at hand in your love. You are already a sacrament to us and for us. May the Lord bring to perfection the good work he has begun in you. My dear friends, you've come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. And you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage. Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you now to stand before your family and friends, join your hands, and declare your consent before God. Lord, bless and consecrate Caitlin and John in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith and remind them always of their love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, please stand. We have heard God's word in sacred scripture. We have felt the Lord's presence in this exchange of vows. Now we ask the Lord to hear our words of prayer, which we offer for John and Caitlin and for the needs of all the world.
In response to our prayers, our Lord, hear us. For our Holy Father on earth, the Pope, all the bishops and the clergy everywhere, they may lead us to a deeper faith in God and a stronger love for others. Let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For our president and all leaders of government, that they may be effective in achieving peace and eliminating poverty. Let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For married persons, that they may continue to give, to be able to forgive, and find happiness deep with the passing of each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
And for John and Caitlin now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love, reaching out to others, and good health until a ripe old age. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help and aided by their friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of John and Kate, and of all present for this wedding, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
And for those personal needs which we mention now in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us. Heavenly Father, your Son taught us to ask, to seek, and to knock. We have done so now, trusting in your mercy. Grant us all that accords with your will for our lives and your world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now let us be seated as we continue with the Mass.
Thank you.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
And for the praise of the Lord in his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, this offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be with you. Lift your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
A mystery of faith.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father,
in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these his servants, now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of one heart in love, by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined in a holy covenant. Please join me in extending the church's blessing by raising your hands toward the couple in prayer. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church, O God, by whom woman is joined to man and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with one blessing not forfeited by original sin nor washed away by the flood. O God, look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down upon them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, and let her always follow the example of those holy men whose praises are sung in the sacred scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments. Made one in the flesh, may they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children. And grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
During our communion procession, we invite you to sing together hymn number 432 on Eagle's Wings, number 432 in the brown hymnal.
Thank you.
sacrifice, O Lord, accompanied with your loving favor, what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union, and replenish with the one bread and the one chalice. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessings. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you all and remain with you forever. Amen. This celebration of God's love is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. And if you all could make them feel like rock stars, that really does something for them. The bridal party. Chris Bird and Mary Kay Rucker, escorted by David Minton. Raise the roof, come on, let's hear it for them. Jen Cessnas, escorted by Michael Burge. Next we have Jessica Church, escorted by Will Burge.
For the second time in the history of the world, our bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. John Burge!
Let's hear it for them, ladies and gentlemen! Caitlin and John are married! What a beautiful day. Is this awesome?
The song they are going to do for the historic first dance is Such Great Heights from the Postal Workers.
All right. Thank you. I tried.
This all on your machine, but God, this is
guys didn't even sweat. That was awesome.
Oh,
That was beautiful. You're not losing one. You're gaining one, and John is going to dance with his mom and the song that they picked out for this moment is What a Wonderful, Wonderful World. Congratulations.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Hey.
I'm Gary Leadham, father of the bride. Thank you so much, everyone, for thank you so much for coming, attendance. Thank you, especially for all those that are from out of town. The Leadham side of this celebration knows who I am. To the Burge side, welcome all. I look forward to meeting all those that I haven't met, and look forward to a wonderful future relationship with not only Rick and Katie, John's parents, but also all of John's brothers, sister, aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, nephews. So, welcome all. And this is a good time to acknowledge the wonderful organization and work that Linda and Katie put in all this. What a great. You know, it's a great time of joy and fun, but our thoughts should also include those that, of the loved ones that watched our couple grow and are unable to attend. So I'd like to just mention a few. Caitlin's grandparents, Bud and Jerry Angel, who passed away in 2000s, and then Bob and Sonny Leadham, who are 90 and 91, and live in Florida, and because of age and health, couldn't make it. And Caitlin's uncle and godfather, Gene Lynch, who, if
if Gene Lynch were here, by the time everybody left, everybody would be saying goodbye, Gene, because he would know everybody and everybody would know him. And also on John's side, Lois Burge, his grandmother, and Chris Conley. So if you would stay seated, please lift your glass for a toast to the loved ones who are not able to attend. We miss you and you're in our prayers. Thank you.
Amen.
As Caitlin's father, I've watched this young lady grow up, and I have experienced the trials and tribulations of raising my youngest daughter. Caitlin was a fairy tale princess that could turn into Freddy Krueger in seconds. Just seconds.
Where's the plug?
Caitlin has many interests. Coming up, she's been well rounded from Girl Scouts to softball to dancing to guitar to violin to piano. She kept her mother running a lot. And unlike her older sister, who has been known to be a little klutzy.
Your trip today
at the during the ceremony. One of the big fears I know all parents have is when children turn 16, and guess what? They get behind the wheel of a 2 or 3 ton vehicle. Well, Kelly, with her older sister, I was worried about that. Especially all the trash cans she knocked over and parking and all this stuff. But with Caitlin, I really didn't have that worry until she backed over the mailbox. And then I started worrying. There is one thing Caitlin has done. She has broken a record that I actually hold. I used to have hold. You fall. She has now become from the Leadham side, the person that holds the record for the longest amount of time to get an undergraduate degree in college. And let me tell you, that was hard to break for me. But she did it.
We'll come back around.
But then, John, you are the answer to my prayers. When I first met John, I was very impressed with how just a nice demeanor, although he was taller than me, one of the few I've met. He impressed me. He had a nice demeanor, very respectful, and handled himself very well. And he does so today also. And I do have one bit of improvement, John, that I would like to recommend. And that is, please improve your technique for tackling and roping. Out of 42 years of marriage, there have been libraries written about successful marriages and tens of thousands of counselors to tell you what a successful marriage is. But I have just a couple to add. Look, part of a successful marriage is falling in love many times. all with the same person. And secondly, a successful marriage is not about finding someone to live with. It's finding someone you can't live without. And I think you two have done a wonderful job of that. So please, if everyone would please stand and join me in a toast to my daughter, Caitlin, the bride. Caitlin, you are a gift from God. I am so grateful to have the honor to be your father. May God continue to bless you and your husband, John, and grant you love, health, and happiness for the rest of your days. Here's to you, baby girl.
God bless you.
Okay, we will do, I'll do a blessing, a short blessing. Lord, thank you for this beautiful day, this wonderful celebration. Our wonderful couple, John and Caitlin, please see us on the way home for everybody that has traveled. And thank you, Lord, for everything you've done for us.
Amen.
Ricky, John's brother, and the best man. Best man. So, I mean, since I'm labeled as such, I'm guessing this is really all about me, right? I just want to start by saying that, Caitlin, you are a wonderful, wonderful person, and I am so glad to know you, and now to have you as a part of our family, and you are also a very charitable person, because you will now be laughing at all of John's jokes for a very long time. And John, oh, there's mom right there. Mom. Sorry for the break there. John, you are also a wonderful, wonderful person because you are related to me. And now John and, I'm sorry, Caitlin and I share something in common. We will have both shared a room with John. However, John, I recommend that it doesn't be in your parents' basement. So. But I wish you both a very long and very wonderful marriage. And I know you will have that because you have such a wonderful example and so many people around here. So here's to John and Caitlin. Yay!
Dad, I couldn't make you a liar, you know? Okay, so I'm Kelly, the matron of honor, and that sounds really old. I like maid of honor better, but Kate's my sister, and I love her to death. I have just met John recently, and I actually love him too, and I know he's going to make a very wonderful husband for Kate, and I'm very happy for them both. I married my best friend. We just celebrated our 11th year wedding anniversary last week. Yeah. And Rob, like Rob says, it's about 8 good years. So I feel blessed marrying my best friend. And then we have our 2 beautiful little girls, and they're such blessings. And I know John and Kate are gonna have blessings to look forward to themselves. And I'm so happy for them. And I'm just delighted. Love you both.
Thanks, matron.
Cutting of the cake. All right, the bride and groom are gonna cut the cake, ladies and gentlemen, so you can have some dessert.
Over here for one.
Lord Jesus.